Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm here once again with my third video. I know I've taken a little bit longer than I would have liked for my third video. However, I'm not here to apologize for not being as productive for my YouTube channel or not, you know, not hustling hard and not pumping out the videos like crazy, like hotcakes and things of this nature. I'm just not going to apologize because, you know, life happens. And in this current overall climate in the world, I think we should apologize for things that are actually, you know, important and not so much for every video. I'm sorry I've taken 2 weeks. I'm sorry I've taken a month or two or whatever, especially now that I'm starting out. So, you know, bear with me and I know you'll understand. So without further ado, I'm here to share with you what's in my pen case. This is actually my teaching pen case, and whenever I have to teach, it's the one that I use, although I'm not teaching as much anymore. Regardless, I thought I would show it to you because I've seen a bunch of pencil cases, and we all love stationery, don't we? So this pencil case here that you can see, I bought in 2018, so 4.5 years ago, more or less, and it got here while I was in hospital, you know. That year, I had to have surgery, you know, just your regular appendectomy. And it just got here when I was in hospital. And I came back and it was here and I just kept using it. And as you can see, if I bring it closer to you, it's a little dirty. I should probably wash it. But, you know, I wanted to show you something that's lived in and something that lived in. Well, you know what I mean. Like, there's a bit of wear and tear. It's a little bit frayed on here. So, you know, it's a bit beat up. But I wanted to show you reality, you know, I wanted to show you reality, and we know that supplies get dirty over time, and if they get dirty, it means that we've been using them. So this is the Lihit Lab Pen Case from 2018. It's the green color, as you can see. It's like a sort of, not lime, but it kind of reminds me of the color of my Nintendo DS from back in the day, like 2009. I had the green one, and the DS was a bit more yellow. But this is more green. I don't know if it makes sense. And I do remember that they had a green one, a black one, a brown one, and an orange one. The inside lining is all the same color. They're all brown. But on the outside, they did have different options. And in hindsight, I think I probably should have bought the black one because the stains and stuff probably wouldn't be as noticeable. And I promise I know more words than probably. My vocabulary reaches further beyond that, I promise. So, you know, I'm gonna show you what I usually carry. And there's a bunch of stuff here. I'm gonna put this notebook here in case I wanna try something and show you what it looks like and so on. So let's start off with this pocket here. There's nothing in the back and it does have these front pockets. So I'm gonna show you what I have in here. Over here in this one, I have these small post-it notes, which I tend to use whenever I have to include answers, for example, on a textbook. You know that if you teach, most of the textbooks don't actually belong to you, but they belong to the school, so you're supposed to take care of them, and you can't just be scribbling on them as much as you want and taking all these notes. So I like to have these. I like to keep these on hand in case I want to write some answers or I want to write some little observations here and there and, you know, just keep going. And when they run out, I just get a new set and that's it. So then in this one here, I have one of these Faber-Castell erasers. I don't know why it's here, because I don't usually keep them here, so that's a little surprise. It's one of the dust-free erasers. You can see right here. These work fine, and they're not pricey at all. They're like 50 cents or something. So, you know, I just keep buying them in different colors and so on and so forth. So now let's open it. As you can see, it's one of these book-type pencil cases or pen cases, whatever you might call them. In school, you know, when I was in primary school, we learned the word pencil case for estuche for school. And so now seeing people call it a pen case seems kind of odd to me. And I feel like every time I say pen case, there's a sort of a red light in my brain that tells me I should be saying pencil case, but whatever. It's a case for your pens. Okay, that's it. So, first part in here, I have three whiteboard markers. I like to use these Pilot V-Board Master whiteboard markers. These are refillable. They come in different colors. Right now, here I have the blue, the green, and the black, but I also have the orange one. I just like orange because it's an unusual color. And I have the red one as well. And just so you see, I want to show you the refills. They look like this. So usually these markers are like 180. I'm talking about euros, okay? They're like 180, and these cartridges are like 130. So, you know, I just keep them and recharge them and just replace this every now and then and refill them. So I have these three, and then I have this Uni Jetstream from Amazon Japan. It's the 0.5 or the 0.5 millimeter pen, and it's the ivory color. As you can see here, it's the ivory color. It's your typical Hobonichi pen. Actually, the Hobonichi pens, the freebie pens, are Jetstream pens. And I bought it last year. I bought three of these last year with my weeks from Amazon Japan. So just for reference, so you can see. So let me just write here. So Uni Jetstream 0.5. And this is the black. And now this is the blue. And this is the red. So just for your reference, and there's my handwriting, as you can see. Now, and then I have this pen that I bought a few days ago, which is the Pilot Super Grip GM in peacock green. I feel like it doesn't look as green on camera, but in real life, it does look green, and you can see the body is see-through, and then it does have this section here. Sorry, there it is. And so again, I'm just going to show you. There it is. Moving on to this section. It's basically the pencil case looks like this. So you have this section here, this one that you can turn, and then the same section on this side. So now let's move on to this one. Here I have a bunch of pens and it's quite messy. So I'm just going to start from the right. These pens I love. I'm going to show them to you together because, yeah, is there another one? No, these three. So these are the Pentel Superb ballpoint pens. I've used these for years at university. I can't tell you how many pages and pages and pages of notes and exams I've written with these ones. These are the, as I said, the Pentel Superb BK77. And it's basically red, purple, and black. So I'm going to show them to you. And here's a tip. There it is. Red, purple, and black. So back to the pencil case. You see, I keep saying pencil case. Anyway, there's not much order to it because I taught a few days ago, and that's how it was, and that's how I wanted to show it to you. I didn't want to organize things way too much for the video. So these are some other pens, some gel pens, thank you very much. Fast dry gel pens from Faber-Castell, and here are the colors. So the green and the turquoise pen. And so again, I'm going to show them to you. So these are more rubbery. They have this rubbery section. And of course, click pens. And let me just show them to you. So again, more pens for me to correct. I like to have different colors also because sometimes when I teach kids, you know, after COVID, people usually bring their own stuff. But even so, I like to have different pens in case they want to ask me to borrow them, because sometimes when I teach kids, they like my pens and they want to borrow them. And, you know, I let them have them. I let them use them to correct their activities when we work on something together, as long as they tell me in English. Of course, that's my only condition. You can have my pink pen if you'd like to correct your assignment with it, but you need to tell me in English. So these are the Faber-Castell, Faber-Castell. Okay, I'm just gonna call them fast dry, fast gel. Okay, so this is one color. And then, whoop, okay, can I hold a pen? Yes. So as you can see, we've got two kinds of greens. And also, I feel like depending on the pen that I'm using, my handwriting changes a bit. So, you know, that's for you to determine as well by looking at it. A regular pencil, this is a Staedtler Norris pen. I think it's the, is it the B? You can't see it anymore because I've used it for a while. It's the 2B. This is the softer pen, and this is your typical Pilot Super Grip mechanical pencil with the black body. I've had this one for years and years and years, probably since I was in college. And I graduated like from my master's, I graduated like 9 years ago. And from my regular degree, my 5-year program, I graduated 10 years ago. So I don't remember when I bought it, but it's quite old and it's still here and I'm still using it. And it's a pencil, so I'm not gonna show you. You know, I'm not gonna swatch it, so to speak. And then I have along with the eraser that you saw, I have this Tombow Nock 3.8 eraser, which is, you know, one of these rechargeable sort of erasers that you do this and you can erase little things here and there, little details. Of course, I don't let the kids have this one. Just in case you're curious, I don't let them have this one, but they can borrow other things. And I also have some other things in the classroom for them to borrow if they want to use them whenever, you know, when I've taught in the past as well. Now, the last two pens from this section are this one from Muji, which is the 0.5 gel pen. It's this berry color, so Muji gel pen 0.5. And this is, I think it was the fuchsia. Right, so there it is. And finally, we've got this pen that, of course, nobody knows about. Nobody has heard anything of, which is the Pentel Energel 0.5 pen. It's the pen. What can I say? It's a pen. Again, I bought like three of these on Amazon. And a box of refills, and I've been using them ever since. I do like, as you can see, 0.5 pens or 0.38. I do have two 0.7 pens and 1 millimeter pen, but I tend to gravitate towards smaller tip sizes in that case because they're, I don't know, I feel like my writing looks better, and if I use bigger tip sizes in pens, it's kind of, I don't know, my letters just look too chunky when I write. So that's why, it's one of the reasons. So, okay, just in case, because I'm sure, you know, you have never seen what this pen writes like. So there you are. There it is. And now, whoops, okay, someone is leaving. Someone is quiet quitting on me. Now, moving right along, in this section, you do have these three pockets, these three mesh kind of pockets. Back when I used to carry my sketchbook around and I used to change the distribution of this pencil case, and I would put different mechanical pencils with different color LEDs to sketch and to make my sketches a little bit more interesting, I would have different colors. So I would have some LED colors here, some LED colors here. And so on. Now I only have one of these cartridges with lead. Okay, and now let's have a look at what's in here in this last section of the pencil case. So first off, I have a clear plastic ruler from Berlitz. I have a pair of scissors in this green, similar to the pencil case, but not quite. Let's see. You know, this is more like my DS from back in the day. And then we've got a leftover Pilot G-Tech C4 pen. I have all the colors, I think, except the yellow one, because I can't really justify it, and it doesn't look that good, to be honest. So Pilot G Tech C4, and this is 0.4. And there it is. Then I have two of these Crayola Super Tips, which are part of a set that I bought a few months ago. I don't have the 100 marker set of these markers, of the Super Tips, because I bought the Fibricolor 100 marker set like 3.5 years ago, I think. They're still there. Some of them are a bit dry and stuff, but I chose the Fibricolor or Fibricolor over these ones because the stand that they come in is hard plastic, so you can just leave them there. It's not like a box where they're like floating around. So yeah, but these ones are the Crayola Super Tips. And just, of course, you've never seen one of these markers before. So let me just do a little wee wee wee, little wiggly lines so that you can see the color. And there's another one. Woo, there you go. There it is. So Crayola Super Tips. Yes. So here they are. Then I have this Tombow Mono correction tape. There's no point in me showing you how this works. And finally, of course, another eraser. I should take one out because I noticed that I have three erasers. I only need, okay, I could have the small one, the pen eraser, and this one. So mono plastic eraser, classic. And then two mild liners. Again, markers that no one has ever seen and no one knows nothing about, especially here on YouTube. So I have, I think, 5 sets, and the only one I don't have is one of the new ones. I'm a bit lost right now. I'm a bit out of touch with the current mild liner releases. I don't own any of the brush markers, so, you know, I'm a little bit behind on that, but I don't even need to catch up at this point. So here's one blue. Just again, let me just show you. So as you know, the mild liners have this kind of chisel tip on one side and then this finer bullet kind of tip on this side. So there's this blue and there's an orange. And there you have it. That's everything I have in my pencil case. I hope you like this video. Tell me what your favorite school supplies are or your favorite pens and stuff. Let's just share these thoughts about these pens. And I'll see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching and subscribing and commenting and all these things. And I hope you have a great day, week, month, whatever, life. Take care. Bye.